This video is sponsored by Skillshare. Hi, it's Michelle from Lab Muffin Beauty Science, chemistry PhD, skincare nerd, and not a big fan of the idea that you have to be rich to afford good skincare products. There is a lot of misinformation about medical grade or clinical or professional skincare products online. You might have heard that these premium priced products that you can usually only get from dermatologists or skin clinics are guaranteed to be more effective or better or less toxic than drugstore or so-called over-the-counter OTC products that you can get from the supermarket and from the pharmacy. You might have heard that non-medical grade products don't provide benefits to your skin, or they're completely useless, or they might even destroy your skin. This is pretty confusing because a lot of dermatologists do recommend cheap, easily available brands that you can get at the drugstore or at the supermarket, like Cetaphil and CeraVe. So what's going on here? Let's talk about medical grade skincare. If you like nerding out about the science behind beauty products, click the like, the subscribe, and the notification bell so you don't miss any videos. Firstly, let's clarify, we're talking about products that are sold at these places for you to take home and use. We're not talking about things like peels that only trained people can use on you while you're at the clinic. We're talking about the products that are like cleansers or serums or toners or moisturizers that are so-called medical grade or clinical. Medical grade skincare products are regulated differently. The first claim is that medical grade skincare is regulated differently by the FDA or whatever relevant authority there is in your particular country. This isn't true. In the US, the vast majority of skincare products are regulated as cosmetics, and so that means they don't need any sort of regulatory approval or proof of effectiveness before they get launched and you can buy them. That doesn't mean that they're not regulated, so they still have to be safe, they can't contain banned ingredients, and they still have to be stable and uncontaminated. This is the case in most places around the world, and this applies to medical grade skincare and drugstore skincare products. There's no legal difference between the two categories. On the other hand, we have drugs, and when it comes to skincare products, this is over-the-counter drugs or prescription drugs. I think a lot of the confusion comes from the use of the phrase over-the-counter. People promoting medical grade skincare products often use this term to describe products that you buy at the drugstore, and they say that over-the-counter products are less effective than medical grade products. In drug regulation, over-the-counter has a legal meaning. It refers to drugs that you can buy without a prescription. And so, over-the-counter drugs are actually more strictly regulated than most medical grade skincare. Over-the-counter drugs include things like sunscreen, aspirin, benzoyl peroxide cream, and antihistamines. This is in contrast to a prescription drug where you need to have a prescription from an appropriately authorized health professional, like a doctor, before you're allowed to buy it. Both over-the-counter drugs and prescription drugs need to be approved before they're allowed to be sold, and part of that approval process is showing that it is effective. There are also different standards for how drugs need to be manufactured compared to cosmetics. Products that are regulated as drugs will be clearly labeled, so in the US, for example, there's the Drug Facts Panel. In Australia, there will be the OSTR or the OSTL number, as well as the concentrations of the active ingredients on the front. In some countries like Japan and Korea, there's also the quasi-drug or cosmeceutical category, and that's also regulated a bit differently from both drugs and cosmetics, but again, that will also be clearly labeled. But with medical grade products, unless they are actually a drug, there's no legal requirement for that sort of labeling. So in legal terms, there's no difference between medical grade and regular skincare products. Both can be regulated as cosmetics or drugs. Usually there's actually less drugs in medical grade skincare than you can get at a drugstore. So over-the-counter skincare drugs include things like sunscreen, benzoyl peroxide creams, adapalene, salicylic acid, and you can find most of these in both medical grade and regular skincare lines. But the majority of medical grade skincare products are cosmetics, and that means they're less regulated in terms of their efficacy than over-the-counter drug skincare products. If you want to go straight for the most effective stuff, you can get prescription-only tazarotene and tretinoin creams. And you won't find these in medical grade skincare lines. You get these literally at the drugstore. There's rigorous testing and research behind medical grade skincare products. They use higher quality ingredients. Then there's the myth that there's always rigorous research and testing that goes into making medical grade skincare products but not normal skincare products, and the idea that they use higher grade ingredients. But medical grade, professional, and clinical aren't regulated terms, and so there is zero guarantee of this. Some medical grade brands will do rigorous testing and clinical studies, but anyone can slap the words medical grade on their products and decide to only sell through skin clinics. And there are lots of regular drugstore skincare products that have rigorous testing and clinical studies as well. Some of the ones that are regulated as drugs, like sunscreen, will have to go through mandatory clinical studies. A lot of the more dermatologist-friendly brands like CeraVe, QV, and Bioderma will have done lots and lots of clinical studies on their products as well. Even the really large mass market brands that a lot of people promoting medical grade products tend to diss, like Olay and Neutrogena, they conduct a lot of clinical studies and scientific research that goes into making their products. Olay are responsible for a lot of the information we know about niacinamide in skincare. Neutrogena do a lot of studies on sunscreens, and both of these brands publish a lot of their research in leading peer-reviewed scientific journals. On the other hand, it's really rare that you see a medical-grade skincare brand publish peer-reviewed scientific research. They contain higher percentages of actives. They're allowed to penetrate deeper than over-the-counter and drugstore products. There are also these myths about the effectiveness of the products. So medical grade skincare products are supposedly allowed to put in higher concentrations of actives, or they're allowed to penetrate deeper into the skin. And so the deeper it goes, the bigger the effect it can have. But again, this is a myth because medical grade has no legal meaning. So there's no regulatory difference, and so there's nothing that they are allowed to do that regular skincare isn't allowed to do. You can get really high percentages of actives from brands like Paula's Choice and The Ordinary, and these are definitely not medical grade skincare. I think the myth of medical grade skincare products being the one true skincare that we should all be using is mostly perpetuated by people who have good intentions, but they've been fed the wrong information by brands who are either being dishonest or should really know better. And that's okay, we've all fallen for marketing myths before. They can be really convincing, especially if they're coming from someone who appears to be really authoritative and knowledgeable. But there's also a small but very vocal group of people online who are using these myths to bully and shame people. They're shaming people for not being rich enough to be able to afford these products or not wanting to spend more on these products because supposedly they don't care about their skin enough. They're bullying people for being so stupid to think that drugstore products can actually work, and they're fear-mongering about drugstore products ruining people's skin. A lot of the time, these people are also selling medical-grade skincare products, and all of this is really not okay. I'm not saying that medical-grade products are bad or they're not worth the price. A lot of them are really good, and a lot of clinical brands do invest in research and hiring scientists who can make their formulations really effective. Ultraceuticals is one of my favorite skincare brands because they put a lot of effort into making their products really effective, and they're in the clinical category. But that's not the case with all medical grade skincare brands, and there are a lot of drugstore brands that also take this sort of approach. Medical grade skincare is just like any other type of skincare, whether it's good or effective or worth the price, or if they have clinical studies to back up their effects, has to be judged on a brand by brand or a product by product basis. There are plenty of drugstore products that work really well, and so you can build an effective skincare routine on a budget. You can also build an effective routine with more expensive medical grade products. So it's perfectly fine to use and promote medical grade skincare products. It's not okay to promote them using myths or to harass people who aren't using these products. And if you sell medical grade skincare products, you shouldn't be using these myths to promote your products anyway. Deceptive marketing is illegal, and people who have been deceived tend not to be very happy about it afterwards. If a product is honestly amazing, you don't have to puff it up with myths about FDA regulation or how deep they can go into your skin or how toxic drugstore products are. If a product has completely transformed your skin or transformed your client's skin, then just say that on its own is very convincing marketing. If there's an amazing team of researchers and formulators who have contributed to making this product, if there are really good before and after photos, if it has actives that you rarely find in other products, then again, just say those things. So those are my thoughts on medical grade skincare. Do you use medical grade skincare? Have you also seen these myths floating around? Let me know in the comments and if there's a myth I've missed out on. Thanks to today's video sponsor Skillshare. They sponsor a lot of educational content on YouTube. Skillshare is an online community that has thousands of classes on a huge range of topics like design, web development, marketing, and analytics. I take all of my Instagram photos on my phone, and I recently switched from Android to iPhone, and so I've had to relearn a lot of my processes. So I decided to go and properly learn how to do phone photography. The class I took was iPhone Photography, How to Take Pro Photos on Your iPhone by Dale McManus. This actually isn't just specific to iPhones. Dell goes through photo composition, and the most useful thing I found was learning how to use the free version of Lightroom. In the past, I was uploading my photos from my phone onto my laptop so I could edit it with Photoshop and then re-download them back onto my phone to post. And so it was really cool to learn how to use a few extra features on my phone so I could skip all that transferring. If you want to check out Skillshare, the first 1,000 people to click the link in the description will get a free trial of the premium membership for a limited time. It's normally less than $10 a month with a yearly subscription. I hope you liked this video. If you did, you can click the like and the subscribe. You can also follow me on Instagram at @labmuffinbeautyscience and check out my blog for more sciencey, nerdy beauty talk. See you next time.